Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. We are discussing on Module 6, Steam Power Cycle, and this is lecture number 2. We recap from the previous lecture 601. In the previous lecture, we studied about the Rankine cycle. We derived the efficiency of the Rankine cycle. We discussed the steam rate, heat rate of the Rankine cycle. And also, we discussed the mean temperature of heat addition. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss the problems on the Rankine cycle. And the learning outcome to the student, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the simple Rankine cycle. We take all the problem from the Anna University question paper so that the student will gain confidence by solving the problem so that it will be very much useful for them to appear for the Anna University examination. And the first example is from the May 2013 question paper. A steam power plant used steam as the working fluid and operates at a boiler pressure of 5 MPa, dry saturated, and a condenser pressure of 5 kPa. Determine the cycle efficiency for 1. Carnot cycle, 2. Rankine cycle. Also, show TS representation of both cycles. So, the given data, P1, initial pressure, the pressure at the entry of the cycle, that is entry of the turbine, P1 equal to P4 equal to 5 MPa, which is equal to 50 bar, and P2 equal to P3 equal to 5 kPa, that is turbine outlet pressure is 5 kPa, which is 0.05 bar. And from the steam table, we have to take the property. It is initially it is dry saturated steam. So from the steam table, P1 equal to 50 bar and dry saturated steam, that is table number 2, pressure table, H1 equal to HG1 equal to 2794.2 kilojoules per kilogram. The saturation temperature is 263.9 degrees Celsius and S1 equal to SG1 equal to 5.974 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the steam table, again, pressure table, at P2 equal to 0.05 bar, TS2 saturation temperature is 32.9 degrees Celsius, HF2 equal to 137.8 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2423.8 kilojoules per kilogram, VF2, that is specific volume of the water, equal to 0.001005 meter cube per kilogram, entropy SF2 equal to 0.476 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 equal to 7.92 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now, so this is the diagram, temperature entropy diagram for the simple Rankine cycle. So, one is the entry of the turbine, two is the exit of the turbine, two to three is the condensation, three is the entry of the pump, and four is the outlet of the pump, and four to one is the heat addition process. So, for the process 1 to 2 in the turbine, so for isentropy expansion in the turbine, S1 equal to S2. So, S1 from the steam table, we have taken 5.974. And S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2 for wet steam. So, 5.974 equal to 0.476 plus X2 into 7.92. So, solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.69. Enthalpy, the dryness fraction of the steam at the outlet of the turbine, X2 equal to 0.69. So, here, quality is 0.69. Now, the specific enthalpy of the steam, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. So, 137.8 plus 0.69 into 2423.8 equal to 1810.2 kilojoules per kilogram. H3, so the, here the enthalpy equal to HF2, which is 137.8 kilojoules per kilogram. And the turbine work equal to H1 minus H2. So, WT equal to H1 minus H2 equal to 2794.2. Minus 1810.2 equal to 984 kilojoules per kilogram. And the pump work, H4 minus H3. So, we already derived H4 minus H3 equal to VF3 into P4 minus P3 into 100. So, this 100 is a multiplication factor for pressure bar into kilopascal, to convert the pressure bar into kilopascal. So, H4 minus H3 equal to pump work equal to 0.001005 into 50 minus 0.05 into 100 equal to 5 kilojoules per kilogram. So, H4 equal to 5 plus 173, 137.8 equal to 142.8 kilojoules per kilogram. So, we have calculated all the enthalpy H1, H2, H3 and H4. Now we calculate the heat supplied in the cycle. So QS or Q1 equal to H1 minus H4 is equal to 2794.2 minus 142.8 equal to 2651.4 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the efficiency of the Carnot cycle, eta C equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. So T2 is the temperature at which heat is rejected and T1 is the temperature at which heat is supplied. So 1 minus 32.9 plus 273 divided by 263.9 plus 273 equal to 0.43, which is 43%. And Rankine cycle efficiency, WT minus WP divided by heat supplied equal to 984 minus 5 divided by 2651.4 equal to 0.369, which is 36.9%. So the answer to the problem, Carnot cycle efficiency is 43% and Rankine cycle efficiency is 36.9%. And we take the second example, a steam power plant operates on a simple ideal Rankine cycle between pressure limit 3 MPa and 50 kPa. The temperature of the steam at the turbine inlet is 300 degrees Celsius and the mass flow rate of the steam through the cycle is 35 kgs per second. Show the cycle on the TS diagram and determine thermal efficiency of the cycle and net power output of the power plant. So the data given, P1 equal to, so this is what the temperature entropy diagram for the superheated cycle, superheated steam at the inlet of the turbine. So one is the superheated steam. So P1 is given as 3 MPa, which is 30 bar, and T1 is given as 300 degrees Celsius. P2 equal to P3 equal to 50 kPa, which is 0.5 bar, and the mass flow rate of the steam equal to 35 kilograms per second. Now from the steam table, superheated steam table, P1 equal to 30 bar and T1 equal to 300 degrees Celsius for superheated steam. Enthalpy of the superheated steam equal to 2995.1 kilojoules per kilogram and the specific entropy of the superheated steam. We have to refer two different tables, specific enthalpy of the superheated steam and specific entropy of the superheated steam. A separate table will be there, so you have to refer to it. So S1 equal to 6.542 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now from the steam table at P2 equal to 0.5 bar, so HF2 equal to 340.6 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2305.4 kilojoules per kilogram and VF2 equal to 0.00103 meter cube per kilogram, SF2 equal to 1.091 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and SFG2 equal to 6.504 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now for isentropy expansion in the turbine, so look at this diagram, S1 equal to S2. So for isentropy expansion, S1 equal to S2. So substituting S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So 6.542 equal to 1.091 plus X2 into 6.504. So solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.84. Now the enthalpy of the steam at the outlet of the turbine, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 340.6 plus 0.84 into 2305.4 equal to 2277.1 kilojoules per kilogram and H3 equal to HF2. So here H3 equal to HF2, saturated liquid, which is directly 340.6. So HF2 equal to 340.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And turbine work WT equal to H1 minus H2, which is 2995.1 minus 2271.1 equal to 718 kilojoules per kilogram. And the pump work equal to WP equal to H4 minus H3, which is VF3 into P4 minus P3 into 100. So substituting all the parameters, 0.00103 into 30 minus 0.5 into 100 equal to 3 kilojoules per kilogram. And H4 equal to 3 plus 340.6 equal to 343.6 kilojoules per kilogram. and heat supplied in the cycle QS equal to H1 minus H4, which is 2995.1 minus 343.6 equal to 2651.5 kilojoules per kilogram. So the Rankine cycle efficiency WT minus WP divided by heat supplied equal to 718 minus 3 divided by 2651.5, that is equal to 26.9%. And net power output of the power plant, P equal to M into WT minus WP, which is equal to 35 into 718 minus 3 equal to 25,025 kilowatts. So, the answer to the problem, Rankine cycle efficiency is 26.9% and net power output of the power plant equal to 25,025 kilowatts. And if we take the example number 3, a power generation plant used steam as the working fluid and operates at a boiler pressure of 50 bar dry saturated and a condenser pressure of 0.05 bar. Determine the cycle efficiency, work ratio and specific steam consumption of the Rankine cycle. And this is from the Anna University question paper, May 2015. So, the given data, P1 equal to 50 bar, P1 equal to P4 equal to 50 bar under dry saturated steam, P2 equal to P3 equal to 0.05 bar, and from the steam table at the P1 equal to 50 bar dry saturated steam, H1 equal to HG1 equal to 2794.2 kilojoules per kilogram, saturation temperature equal to 263.9 degrees Celsius, and S1 equal to SG1 equal to 5.974 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the steam table, again from the steam table, at P2 equal to 0.05 bar, HF2 equal to 137.8 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2423.8 kilojoules per kilogram, and VF2 equal to 0.001005 meter cube per kilogram, SF2 equal to 0.476 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 equal to 7.92 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And for the isentropic turbine, so this is the isentropic expansion in the turbine. This is the TS diagram for the Rankine cycle, simple Rankine cycle. So, inlet condition of the turbine is dry saturated steam. So, here it is wet steam. So, S1 equal to S2. So, using the expression S1 equal to S2, S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So, substitute the numerical values, S1 equal to 5.974, SF2 equal to 0.476, and SFG2 equal to 7.92, solving this equation, we'll get X2 equal to 0.69. So, the quality of the steam at the outlet of the turbine is 0.69. And we calculate the specific enthalpy of the steam, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. So, 137.8 plus 0.69 into 2423.8 equal to 1810.2 kilojoules per kilogram. And H3 equal to HF2, which is 137.8. kilojoules per kilogram. Now, the turbine work equal to H1 minus H2. So, WT equal to H1 minus H2, which is 2794.2 minus 1810.2 equal to 984 kilojoules per kilogram. And the pump work equal to H4 minus H3, which is VF3 into P4 minus P3 into 100. So, this is 0.001005 into 50 minus 0.05 into 100 equal to 5 kilojoules per kilogram. And H4 equal to H3 plus 5, so 5 plus 137.8 equal to 142.8 kilojoules per kilogram. We have calculated all the enthalpy, now we calculate the heat supplied QS equal to H1 minus H4, which is 2794.2 minus 142.8 equal to 2651.4. So, we calculate the Rankine cycle efficiency. Eta equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supplied. So, this 984.-5 divided by 2651.4 equal to 0.369, which is 36.9%. And the work ratio is defined as net to work output divided by the turbine work. So, WT minus WP divided by WT equal to 984-5 divided by 984 equal to 0.99. The specific steam consumption or steam rate, so, SR equal to 3600 divided by WT minus WP equal to 3600 divided by 984 minus 5 equal to 3.67 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So what do you mean by this? So the power plant, it requires 3.67 kilograms per kilograms of steam per kilowatt hour. That is, to produce one unit of power, it requires 3.67 kilograms of steam. So the answer to the problem, Rankine cycle efficiency is 36.9%, work ratio is 0.99, steam rate is 3.67 kilogram per kilowatt hour. And example number 4, steam at 50 bar 400 degrees Celsius expands in a Rankine cycle to 0.34 bar. The mass flow rate is 150 kilograms per second of steam. Determine power developed, thermal efficiency, specific steam consumption. And this is from May 2013 question paper. This is again inlet is superheated steam. So P2 equal to 50 bar, T1 equal to 400 degrees Celsius, P2 equal to P3 equal to 0.34 bar, and mass flow rate is 150 kilograms per second. So this is the temperature entropy diagram for a turbine with a superheated steam at the entry. So 1 is the superheated steam, 2 is the wet steam, 3 is the saturated liquid, and 4 is the unsaturated liquid. Now we refer to the steam table. So from the steam table at the 50 bar 400 degrees Celsius for superheated steam. So enthalpy of the superheated steam is 3198.3 kilojoules per kilogram, and the entropy of the superheated steam 6.651. So you have to refer two different tables. Specific enthalpy of superheated steam, that is one table, and specific entropy of superheated steam, that is another table. Then from the exit, so at the 0.34 bar, P2 equal to 0.34 bar, so HF2 equal to 301.5 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2328.9 kilojoules per kilogram, VF2 equal to 0.001024 meter cube per kilogram, SF2 equal to 0.98 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 equal to 6.747 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now for isentropic expansion 1 to 2, S1 equal to S2. So for isentropic expansion in the turbine, S1 equal to S2. So S1 we have taken, and S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So 6.651 equal to 0.98 plus X2 is the unknown into 6.747. Solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.84. Then the enthalpy of the steam at the outlet of the turbine, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 301.5 plus 0.84 into 2328.9, which is 2257.7 kilojoules per kilogram, and H3 equal to HF2 equal to, so this is H3, so H3 equal to the saturated liquid, HF2, so H3 equal to HF2 equal to 301.5 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the turbine work equal to H1 minus H2, which is 3198.3 minus 2257.7 equal to 940.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And the pump work, WP equal to H4 minus H3, which is VF3 into P4 minus P3 into 100. So substituting 0.001024 into 50 minus 0.34 into 100 equal to 5.08 kilojoules per kilogram, and H4 equal to 5.08 plus H3. Which is 301.5, which is 306.58 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the amount of heat supplied, QS equal to H1 minus H4 equal to 3198.3 minus 306.58 equal to 2891.72 kilojoules per kilogram. So we have calculated all the parameters, H1, H2, H3, H4, and we have calculated the turbine work, pump work, and the heat supply. Now, we will go for the calculation of answers. First, the Rankine cycle efficiency, which is WT minus WP divided by QS, 940.6 minus 5.08 divided by 2891.72 equal to 0.323, which is 32.3%. Net power output of the plant, M into WT minus WP, so 150 into 940.6 minus 5.08 equal to 140,328 kilowatt. The specific steam consumption of the steam rate equal to 3600 divided by WT minus WP equal to 3600 over 940.6 minus 5.08 equal to 3.84 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So the answer to the problem, Rankine cycle efficiency is 32.3%. Net power output equal to 140.3 megawatt and the steam rate equal to 3.84 kilogram per kilowatt hour. And example number 5 from the annoyance to question paper November 2017, a cyclic steam power plant is to be designed for a steam temperature at the turbine inlet of 633 Kelvin and an exhaust pressure of 8 kilopascal. After isentropic expansion of the steam in a turbine, the moisture content in the turbine exhaust is not to exceed 15%. Determine the greatest allowable steam pressure at the turbine inlet and calculate the Rankine cycle efficiency of the steam condition. Also estimate the mean temperature of heat addition. And a given condition T1, turbine temperature at the inlet of the turbine T1 equal to 633 Kelvin, which is 360 degrees Celsius. P2 equal to P3, turbine outlet pressure is 8 kilopascal, which is 0.08 bar. X1 equal to X2, that is, the moisture content is 15%. So, dryness fraction equal to 1 minus 0.15 equal to 0.85. So, from the steam table at 0.08 bar, HF2 equal to 173.9 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG2 equal to 2403.2 kilojoules per kilogram, VF2 equal to 0.001008 meter cube per kilogram, SF2 equal to 0.593 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and SFG2 equal to 7.637 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now, the properties of the steam at the outlet of the turbine, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, substitute the numerical values 173.9 plus 0.85 into 2403.2 equal to 2216.62. And the entropy equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2, substitute in numerical values 0.593 plus 0.85 into 7.637 equal to 7.084 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now, for the inlet condition, we have to go for interpolation. The reference, what is reference available is, we have the entropy is constant. So, entropy S1 equal to S2, that is what the reference. So, entropy S1. Is 7.084. Now we have to get the 7.084. So entropy S1 should be S1 equal to S2 7.084. Now how to get the value? So the green color, the area, first we calculate the entropy. First we take the entropy interpolation. We have data for 16 bar, 17 bar and 350 degree Celsius, 400 degree Celsius. So, this is what the data available in the steam table. Specific entropy of superheated steam. So, we have data for 16 bar, 350 degree Celsius, 16 bar, 400 degree Celsius, 17 bar, 350 degree Celsius and 17 bar, 400 degree Celsius. So, entropy is 7.239. Now, we take 360 degree Celsius. So, we calculate 7.1054. Similarly, here 360 degree Celsius 7.0756. So, 350 plus 400 minus 350 into 0.2 equal to 360. This is the logic. Linear interpolation. 350 plus 10 equal to 350 plus 10 equal to 360. So, from 400 minus 350 equal to 50 into 0.2 equal to 10. Now, 16 bar. So, how to interpolate 16 bar? The same logic. 350. So, 7.072 plus 7.239. Minus 7.072 into 0.2 equal to 7.1054. So, this value 7.1054. For 17 bar, 7.042 plus 7.21 minus 7.042 into 0.2 equal to 7.0756. So, this value. Now, our entropy S2 equal to S1, S2 equal to 7.084 is in between these two. Now, once again interpolate. 7.1054 minus 7.1054 minus 7.0756 into x equal to 7.084. So this value we know, but we should know what is the fraction x value. So x value equal to 0.718. Now you calculate the pressure P1 equal to 16 minus 17 into 0.718 equal to 16.718 bar. So the pressure at the inlet of the turbine is 16.718 bar. So this is how, so actually the value given available in the steam table, from the value available in the steam table, we have to interpolate the pressure at the entry of the turbine, 16.718 bar. And a similar way we can interpolate for the enthalpy, and the enthalpy here at this pressure equal to 3167 kilojoules per kilogram. So this is what the data we require, the enthalpy at the inlet of the turbine, 3167 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the specific enthalpy of the pump, H3 equal to, HF3 equal to 173.9 kilojoules per kilogram, H4 minus H3 equal to VF3 into P4 minus P3, which is 0.001008. Into 16.718 minus 0.08 into 100 equal to 1.677 kilojoules per kilogram. So H4 equal to 1.677 plus 173.9 equal to 175.577 kilojoules per kilogram. So Rankine cycle, to calculate the Rankine cycle efficiency, we calculate WT, H1 minus H2, which is 3167 minus 2216.62 equal to 950.38 kilojoules per kilogram. WP, H4 minus H3 equal to 1.677 kilojoules per kilogram. Heat supplied, H1 minus H4 equal to 3167 minus 175.577 equal to 2991.423 kilojoules per kilogram. And efficiency equal to WT minus WP divided by heat supplied, which is 950.38 minus 1.677 divided by 2991.423 equal to 31.317, which is 31.7%. And mean temperature of heat addition, Tm equal to H1 minus H4 divided by S1 minus S4. This is 3167 minus 175.577 divided by 7.084 minus 0.593, which is equal to 460.85 Kelvin or 187.85 degree Celsius. So the answer to the problem, Rankine cycle efficiency is 31.7% and mean temperature of heat addition is 187.85 degree Celsius. We take another example on the simple Rankine cycle, example number 6 from the Anna University question paper November 2012. A steam turbine admits steam at 30 into 10 power 5 newtons per meter square, superheated 420 degrees Celsius, and discharges it at 0.2 into 10 power 5 newtons per meter square with a dryness fraction of 0.92. What is the isentropic efficiency of the turbine? So the given data, P1 equal to, so you refer to the diagram. In the HS diagram, 1 to 2 is the isentropic expansion, 1 to 2 dash is the actual expansion. So, P1 is given as 30 bar here, T1 is 420 degrees Celsius and P2 equal to 0.2 bar and X2 dash entropy, dryness fraction, actual dryness fraction is given as 0.92. So, from the superheated steam table, P1 equal to 30 bar and T1 equal to 420 degrees Celsius, we take enthalpy equal to 3277.24 kilojoules per kilogram and the entropy equal to 6.987 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And from the steam table, 0.2 bar, HF2 equal to 251.5 kilojoules per kilogram and HFG2 equal to 2358.4 kilojoules per kilogram and SF2 equal to 0.832 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, SFG2 equal to 7.077 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now we know for isentropic expansion between 1 and 2, S1 equal to S2, so S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So 6.987 equal to 0.832 plus X2 into 7.077, solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.87. So here X2 equal to 0.87 and here X2 dash is given in the problem as 0.92. Now isentropic enthalpy at the exit, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 251.5 plus 0.87 into 2358.4 equal to 2303.31 kilojoules per kilogram. Actual enthalpy at the exit, H2 dash equal to HF2 plus X2 dash into HFG2, which is 251.5 plus 0.92 into 2358.4 equal to 2421.22 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the turbine efficiency, eta T equal to WA by WS, H1 minus H2 dash divided by H1 minus H2. So, 3277.24 minus 2421.22 divided by 3277.24 minus 2303.31 equal to 0.879, which is 87.9%. So, the question is here, you have to calculate the turbine efficiency. So, the turbine efficiency is isentropic efficiency turbine, which is calculated as 0.87. That is the answer to the problem. So, we stop here. So, these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And you can write to my mail ID. I will answer for any queries. Thank you for watching. We'll meet again.